Wes McCammon, and this is the YouTube Movie Deal Tag. I was tagged by an average madman, link in the description, who tagged me in this YouTube Movie Deal Tag. So there are a couple of questions that are in this tag that I need to answer, so here we go. The first film you remember ever seeing. The problem is I'm so old that my memory doesn't go back that far. It was probably one of these three. I have a vague memory of seeing Star Trek II in a drive-in movie theater. Now, that movie came out in 82, which means I would have been 10 years old, and I vaguely remember seeing it on the big drive-in screen, and the scene I remember is the, you know, the Spock death scene, and it seemed like I remember it because the image seemed to be stretched, but I don't remember anything else about the movie, or about even the situation or who I was with, even as odd as that sounds. So that was one. My town had a very tiny theater at the time, and with only one screen, obviously, because it was a long time ago. And I remember seeing Popeye, starring Robin Williams, at that theater. And another movie that's probably one of my favorites called The Private Eyes, with Don Knotts and Tim Conway. And, man, that was a good movie.
Who better to solve England's most puzzling mystery than these two international crime busters?
Yes?
Good day. I'm Inspector Winship, and this is my assistant, Dr. Tart.
With the law and the order.
Gathering vital clues from every available source.
Well.
Step by step, Tim Conway and Don Knotts prove murder can be deadly in The Private Eyes. Who will be the next victim?
Got that message? Better send it off to the yard and let them know we're here.
I suspect that they would like to see me dead.
Well, you can relax now that we're here.
Danger is their constant companion. Fear is an unknown factor.
Dark! What?
These people are dropping like flies. Don't you people realize that you're next unless we get to the bottom of this?
Tea isn't supposed to foam. Here. Stir it.
These great sleuths, given the clue, come up with the perfect solution.
Hey, we must be near a bowling alley.
That we have among us a murderer. And that killer is right here in this room. All right, hold it right there. Gun, give me your gun.
Tim Conway is the dim-witted Dr. Tart. And Don Knotts is the inept Inspector Winship.
Tart!
In...
Oh, my gosh.
The Private Eye.
But, it was probably somewhere in that area. I actually don't remember the first movie I ever saw. I just don't remember. Is it possible to have a favorite film? If so, what's yours? It's one of those things where you say, of course I have a favorite film. And then you think of it and you think of hundreds of favorite films. I tend to agree with Jacob. I think it's more of a list of your favorite films. And I have more of a list of films for each like category. Like I have a favorite horror film. I have a favorite Friday the 13th film. I have a favorite comedic film. I have a favorite sketch comedy film. I mean, there are so many different categories. You end up with almost every movie in its own category of it and its own favorite, if that makes sense. So I really couldn't answer what my favorite movie is. Throughout this video, you'll hear several movies that I've already mentioned that I really enjoy. But I have to put The Private Eyes up there as one of them. That's my absolute favorite. Oscar is another really good film that I find hilariously funny. If you've never seen Oscar, it's Sylvester Stallone, and it's a comedy starring Sylvester Stallone, and it's a really, really good, it's a really good movie. Kind of older. So the next question is, what films make you cry? Titanic. I know, it's cliche, but I really, really do enjoy Titanic. It's one of my favorite movies of all time. Granted, you know, it's long. It has some dead weak spots, but I'm quite the Titanic buff anyway. Like, I enjoy the history of it. Like, I could spend hours on reading the history of the passengers and the ship itself. But anyway, that being said, Titanic makes me cry. Still does. Steel Magnolias is another movie that really gets me really emotional. And finally, the third movie that I get really emotional over is a movie called Beaches, with Bette Midler. I really enjoy Beaches with Bette Midler. That movie really is an emotional one for me. So yeah, those are some really good emotional movies. What movie would you magically like to climb into the world of? I suppose I could get away with saying Doctor Who, because there were a couple of movies made in the 1960s, but those really aren't canon, so we're not going to say Doctor Who, because I don't want to be in those movies. So probably I'm going to have to go with the Star Trek movies. That would probably be the world I would want to enter, and only if I could be young enough to enter Starfleet. And then if I had to choose another one, it would be, like Jacob said, Harry Potter. The Harry Potter world. And then again, only if I could be a wizard. What movie character do you wish you were more like? I would probably have to say Spock. From Star Trek, obviously. I really am envious of his control of his of emotions. And he's really smart. And I want to be smarter. Plus, it'd be cool to do that neck thing. How have movies influenced you on YouTube or elsewhere in your life? I'm not sure how they have influenced me in life or really my channel. I just know, or I just got the feeling, and I enjoy movies to the extent that I knew that I had the desire to put what's in my head out into the world. And to put something creative that I made out. I think that's kind of the best thing I got from watching movies, is the fact that I knew I wanted to create. And I think Doctor Who Fan Audio Adventures has been a really great outlet for that. It's allowed me to use people from around the world for kind of my own twisted sense of creativity without us having to actually be in the same city, even the same country. And it still has allowed me to create these magical, wonderful adventures that I enjoy. Very few people know this, because I haven't promoted it very much, but starting around 1986, I started writing my own scripts for a Star Trek series. I wrote these all through high school, mostly through college as well, into adulthood. I wrote these scripts. If you ever wanted to check them out, some of them are online, not many of them. I have notebooks and notebooks and notebooks full of writing. A couple of years ago, I tried to start putting them online, and I just got tired of doing it. But anyway, the website is stlost.com, because the series was called Star Trek: The Lost Generation. If you check back on the channel, you'll see a couple of videos. We actually filmed several scenes for the one episode. I called it Special Episode 50 at the time, because it was the 50th episode that I had written. And so we actually did some filming around that, and I kind of pieced it together. Back when computers were in their very early stages, and I first started getting into video editing, I tried to piece these together in something that was semi-watchable, and I think that's posted, or at least the trailer for it is posted posted online on this YouTube channel, on my YouTube channel. But anyway, that was my big creative outlet, I think, all through school. Kind of kept me grounded and kind of sane. This was closer to the end of the 1980s when Doctor Who was kind of losing popularity in it, and several of the local stations had dropped showing it altogether. For instance, I only saw Sylvester McCoy's first series as broadcast on television. After that, they stopped showing them altogether in the United States, and so I kind of picked Star Trek up as a, I wouldn't want to say a replacement, but as a another choice of science fiction show. And so started writing, incorporated my friends into the script, and came up with this interesting story. Now, for those of you who know about Blake Seven, if you look at the scripts that I wrote, you very definitely get a Blake Seven feel. In I think it's episode 7 or 8, we find out that the Federation has been corrupted, and basically the Enterprise goes on the run as a rebellion ship, and so it, from that point forward, it feels much more like Blake Seven than Star Trek, I think, because I was also watching Blake Seven started showing around that time as well, and so it has a very darker tone to it than something on Star Trek, and of course then the morals become questionable, you know, and one of the characters is you know, his morals are particularly questionable, and so it's an interesting series. It's an interesting read, I think. Please don't be too critical. You have to remember that these were written by my 14-year-old self. So they aren't terribly good. They get better over time, but still. Even my 20-year-old self wasn't a great writer. Hell, my 40-year-old self isn't a great writer. You know, thankfully, we've got some really good writers for Dr. Fan Audio Adventures, or we'd be up a creek. Take it with a grain of salt. If you're interested and you want to go read about the characters, the website is something I made a long, long time ago and I haven't updated it in years. Feel free to go look at it if you'd like to, you know, whatever. Tell me what you think. But, you know, the website is old and hasn't been updated in a long time. But anyway, what films do you hate? I don't know. I don't like Westerns. I don't like Westerns. I don't enjoy them. I don't enjoy the gunslinging in the Old West type shows, TV shows or movies. I don't enjoy that particular genre at all. Black and white films are hard for me to watch. And I'm not sure why that is. It's just something about, I don't know, maybe I grew up in the color generation, and it's just something about black and white films and TV shows that are really hard for me to watch. It's kind of like a turnoff or something. I don't know what it is. I don't enjoy the Twilight series. I don't know that I hate it. I know that Jacob mentioned the Twilight series. I don't really like that at all. Let's see. Movies that I just absolutely hate. Nope, can't think of one, other than the ones I mentioned, but Westerns. I think I'll just go with Westerns. Most Westerns I don't like. I haven't seen a Western that I enjoyed. Don't like the whole horses, desert thing. I don't like it. Saloons. Yeah, not my cup of tea. Don't like any of those. Okay, so I'm supposed to tag somebody, I believe, and so of course I'm going to tag Colin, who is one of my co-producers in Dr. Fan Audio Adventures, and I'll tag Tom as well. So Colin and Tom, let's hear your YouTube movie deal tags. All right, thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you'd like, and like the video if you like, and don't forget to follow me on Twitter at PisgahScience2, Snapchat at PisgahScience, Twitter, PisgahScience2, I already said that. Instagram at RLWRM, and pretty much Pisgah Science everywhere on the web. Thanks. Bye.